Good morning, my dear children. We have completed till line number 20, Merchant of Venice, Act 3, Scene 2. So today we'll start from line number 21. Till line number 20, what we have seen? That Portia requesting Bassanio to stay longer in Belmont so that she can enjoy his company for a longer period of time. Bassanio, on the other hand, does not want to do so. He wants to take part in it as quickly as possible. So here we start from line number 21. Let fortune go to hell for it, not I. She wants fortune to go to hell. That means if Bassanio fails in the game of casket, then it is going to be misfortune to Portia. And she does not care about that very matter. She'll feel no problem if Bassanio fails in the game of casket. In that case, what will happen to fortune? Fortune will surely go to hell. That means the fortune will experience a huge defeat. Not I. She does not want to go to hell by breaking her father's promise. By breaking that very promise that she has made to her father. So she will not help Bassanio. And she will not help because she does not want to go to hell. That is why it is written not I. In that case, if fortune goes to hell, she does not care. I speak too long. Yes, you are speaking too long, Portia. It is going to be line number 22. So it's a soliloquy, so obviously a long speech. But it's to seize the time. So why is she speaking too long? Only to prolong the matter, only to stretch the time, to eke it. It means to stretch it and to draw it out in length. That means to make the duration longer. Duration of what? Her conversation with Bassanio. So why is she speaking so long? To pace the time, to prolong the time, or to stretch the time, to make it longer so she can have little more company with, little longer company of Bassanio. To stay you from election. To stay Bassanio out of election, because the game of casket, election of the casket, it's a kind of hazard, very risky business. Next, Bassanio speech 25. Let me choose. See, he does not want to do the same thing. He wants to choose as quickly as possible. For as I am, I leap the rack, I leap upon the rack. He is living in utmost tension. So what is rag? Rag is a kind of instrument that was heavily used during the medieval period, some 11th, 12th and 13th century, to punish the criminals, to punish the convicts. Both the legs were tied, both the hands were tied, and from the opposite direction, four horse were employed to stretch the very person, that criminal, from all the sides. I am adding the picture of this one along with this one. Do go through that picture also, you will understand. So from both the sides, the tension will be there and the person will get torn into pieces. That means it is a very painful death for that very person. So that is called rack. So Bassanio's situation is like that. He is living the life in huge tension. From both the sides he is stretched. How is he stretched? One side he is stretched due to that game of casket. That's a huge barrier for him to win his desire, to win his beloved Portia. Another side, what is the problem? Problem is his love. And other things, just like the 3000 ducat he has borrowed. So all these problems are there in one side, that is stretching him, another side, that is game of caskets. So there is a huge problem for Bassanio. So he wants to say what? He wants to say that he is in a great tension, but this tension is not that Portia loves him, that is why he is in tension. He is in tension because he cannot express his love to Portia, because there is the problem of game of casket. Further, he has taken 3,000 ducats. That is another tension. And another side, he is stretched by that game of cascade because luck is uncertain. Now, Portia misunderstood that very matter. She thought Bassanio is in problem due to her. Since she speaks too long, since she likes Bassanio, that is why Bassanio is in tension. So she misunderstood that very matter. He's saying, upon the rack, Bassanio, you are in tension, Bassanio. Then confess, unfold, speak out. What treason there is? Treason stands for impurity or cheating. Impurity or cheating. Mingled means mixed with your love. So Portia feels Bassanio is in tension because Bassanio's love is not pure. There is some sort of cheating or impurity mixed with Bassanio's love. Bassanio is justifying what he actually meant. So this is the justification of Bassanio, of that claim made by Portia, which claimed that Bassanio's love does have some impurity. None but the ugly treason of mistrust. So there is nothing specific regarding Portia, but he has only one tension. There is the tension of mistrust or doubt, which makes me fear the enjoying of my love, and the doubt does not allow him to enjoy his love to the fullest. He feels that he may not get his love. He may lose the game of cascade and will fail to win the hands of Portia. So there is no specific thing related to his love. There is no impurity in his love. But what is the problem? The only problem is that he has doubt, mistrust on what? On his love. He cannot trust his love. He has plenty of doubts for his love. He cannot enjoy his love to the fullest. And he is afraid of enjoying his love. Because of what? Because of this very uncertain period, because of this doubtful situation, very puzzling situation. There may as well be Amitian life. Between snow and fire, as treason and my love. There may be a meeting, means friendship, between snow and fire. Where it is written as, just write down if there is link between treason and my love. There may as well be a meeting like between snow and fire. As will be a Amitian, as treason in my love. If Bassanio's love does have impurity in it, does have some cheating in it, then it will be a phenomenon. There will be friendship between snow and fire. So the friendship between snow and fire is never possible. Similarly, there is no possibility of any kind of impurity in Bassanio's love. If there is something, if there is impurity in Bassanio's love, then there will be friendship between fire and snow. So he justifies that he has no impurity in his love. Portia, yes, it is written A, means yes. I feel you speak upon the rack. Portia is still talking about that very term, rack. She is afraid because what? Because Bassanio talked of rack, where men enforced means under pressure, under tension, or under force, do speak anything. If men are under pressure, this is the personal concept of Portia regarding men, male community, that if the men are going to be forced or under pressure, they do speak anything. So they can speak anything. Promise me life and I will confess the truth. Now line number 35, it is little melodramatic. Melodramatic means it is hyperbolic very much. Where we are going to see Bassanio acts as a convict, a criminal, and Portia is going to act as executioner. Executioner means who execute the punishment, means who cuts the head, beheads, or who hangs the criminal. They are called executioner. So here Portia behaves like an executioner, while Bassanio behaves like one convict. Bassanio, promise me life and I will confess the truth. If Portia allows him to live his life, then he can tell the truth. Confess means speak out the truth. Portia, well then confess and live. Portia here acts as a perfect executioner. Executioner, we locally call it Jallad or Jallad. Jallad in Bengali, Jallad in Hindi. So she acts as a perfect executioner, saying that you confess what is there inside your heart and leave. Basically, an executioner says what? Says that confess what is there inside your heart before your death and then you die. So the last wish is going to be said by the executioner and then he will be hanged to death or cut into pieces or beheaded. Here it is the opposite. Portia saying the confess and leave. Bassanio, confess and love. So Bassanio's confession is that he is in love. Love with whom? With Portia. Had been the very sum means summary of my confession. So the very summary, little summary of his confession is what? He is in love. Love with whom? Love with Portia. Oh, happy torments. Torment means torture. Torture that is happy. Example of oxymoron, torment and happy, two opposite things juxtaposed or mixed together. So it is an example of oxymoron. Oh, happy torment, when my torturer does teach me answer for deliverance. Who is the torturer? Portia is the torturer. Portia does teach me means does helps me or guide me the answer. For deliverance, that means the answer to remain safe. So the torturer herself is doing what? Herself is saving, providing ointment, providing cure to Bassanio. So that is why the torture is happy. But led me to my fortune and the casket. But led me means take Bassanio to his fortune and the casket, because his fortune depends on the game of casket. Curtain drawn from the before the casket. So till now, line number 41. We'll continue in the next video. Thank you.